From popes to saints, two Catholic giants, Pope John Paul II and John the 23rd, have both officially entered sainthood. Billions of pilgrims gathered in St. Peter's Square to witness the historic canonization today. So for that, with us this morning is Patrick Hornbeck, Chair of Theology at Fordham University. Patrick, thanks so much for being with us.
Morgan, thanks for having me back.
Absolutely. So let's jump right into it. Why is this so historic? What's so unique about this?
Well, the Catholic Church over the past 2,000 years has canonized about 80 popes at different points, but never two on the same day.
So why now?
Well, it's fascinating. These are both giant popes you mentioned of the 20th century. John the 23rd convened the Second Vatican Council in the 1960s. It changed Catholicism so much into the modern era. The Mass was said in English, the priests turned around and faced the people, the church talked about openness to other religions. And then John Paul II was the second longest reigning pope of any time, and played a really significant role in bringing down communism as well. And so these are two really different kind of figures, and I think it says something about this current pope, Pope Francis, that he wants to honor both of them on the same day.
So speaking of that, what message is he trying to send? Is he trying to unify the Catholic Church?
Oh, absolutely. I think the message is these are all Catholics, right? This is not just the liberal pope, it's not just the conservative pope. He's saying both of these people are to be regarded as saints, and that, in a sense, making their respective devotees and followers come to St. Peter's Square on the same day and do homage to both of these men, I think that's a really important political statement.
But everyone's not so excited about this homage. I mean, let's talk about John Paul. Some say, look, this is just too hasty, just 9 years after his death. But I'm wondering, why is 9 years considered too hasty?
Well, that's like 5 minutes in Catholic Church time. We're talking about an institution that runs over 2,000 years. And oftentimes people have had to wait a century or two centuries to be canonized. But at John Paul II's funeral, Morgan, in 2005, there were people there with banners that said, make him a saint now.
But why? Why was it fast-tracked then?
Well, so the pope that came after John Paul II, Benedict XVI, was his closest collaborator.
Okay.
A close friend of his. He recognized the really significant influence that John Paul had in the 115 countries that he visited. And so Benedict moved John Paul II's case forward. With John the 23rd, Francis, the current pope, actually made another exception to make his case move forward a little bit faster. So maybe we're just seeing that the Vatican timescale is speeding up a little bit.
So this is just 9 years, is but a blink of the eye.
Just a blink of the eye.
Got it. Okay. Yeah. But some are also saying that John Paul was too slow to grasp the seriousness of the sexual abuse claims. Mm-hmm. Is that affecting his legacy today?
I think it's part of the debate. And I don't know, a century from now, when historians look back and write the history of John Paul II, I think there's going to be lights and there's going to be shadows in that history. And I think one of the biggest shadows is going to be that John Paul II believed so much in the Catholic priesthood that I just don't think imaginatively he was able to get his head into recognizing what was really happening.
The gravity of the situation.
And we don't also know how much he was told. Mm-hmm. So I think there's a lot of unanswered questions that historians are going to have to ask as time goes on.
Given all those unanswered questions, do you think that will affect the way the Vatican handles these claims in the future?
I don't think so. I think that in the Catholic Church, once you make a saint, that person's a saint. There's not an unmaking saint process as it goes on. I don't know. I think we're going to have to see a lot about what happens to Catholicism in general over the course of the next couple decades. Will more popes be like John Paul II? Or will more popes be like Francis and John the 23rd?
So let's talk about John the 23rd quickly. We understand that the need for the second miracle was waived. Now, what defines a miracle? And secondly, why was it waived in this case?
Well, like everything else in the Vatican, there are committees that make these sorts of decisions. Okay. There's a congregation called the Congregation for the Causes of Saints. And there are doctors involved, there are scientists involved. I think one of the greatest miracles, maybe not as supernatural, but when we look back in time, John the 22nd called the Second Vatican Council. He surprised everybody. He created a space for a new modern Catholicism that most people don't know any different from. You know, people today know this Catholicism as their Catholicism. And that in and of itself, in an institution that goes on for centuries, might be the greatest miracle of all.
And a big deal on a day like today. Thank
you
so much. Patrick Hornbeck, Chair of Theology at Fordham University. Thanks so much for joining us
today. Thank you.